Hello everyone, this is going to be the very first work in progress of the 1144 High Grade Kshatriya, the knockoff that I bought. I got it from Yo-Yo Base. Now, first thing I should probably mention, I did email the guy last week, a couple days ago, and he said that, okay, apparently this, okay, the sort. He can't, I have no idea what's going on, but he can't get the store anymore. He don't buy anything from there. Something about mod chips, I have no idea what he's talking about, but yeah, apparently that store doesn't, it's there, but it's not really, so don't try to buy from them, because it's not going to work. FYI. Yeah, it was a nice little run while it lasted, but hey, since I don't have to review this thing now, I'm just going to paint the crap out of it. And I've actually started already. I started 2 days ago, and I've actually got a lot painted. And this is why I like having the knockoff, because I'm actually trying something. I have no idea if it's gonna work at all. Basically, I'm gonna take the whole thing. See, what I originally planned to do was take the parts here, and I was gonna take the main body. Basically, anything you see that is black was gonna be, remember that pearl red I had from my Blitzexia? It actually turns into like a pink. I was gonna use that for the black. And then all the detail on those parts were gonna be, instead of being white like they normally would, we're gonna be in black. And then I was gonna do all the light green that you see in the limbs and the head and the binders were going to be silver. And then I was going to do all the white parts in black, and then all the yellow parts in copper, and then the darker parts in the main body and the skirt armor was probably going to be like a metallic red, which I still have some left over. And that was the plan. And then I started to paint the black parts with the pearl red. I had a little bit less left, and I ran out. I almost had the ball done, and I ran out. Actually, here's one piece, and I might keep it this color. Once I assemble it, I'm going to see what it looks like with just this one piece, which is basically the cockpit cover, I guess. I'm pretty sure. And I ran out. I couldn't finish the other parts, so I've actually decided to paint those parts this nice light blue. And still, I'm going to detail the what would normally be white and black. Probably going to have to use a toothpick, because I don't have a paintbrush small enough without, you know, risk of actually going over and smudging. So I've done that. So I already had to modify my design. Then, I already had all the yellow parts painted in the copper. They look really good. I'll actually show you a couple of pieces here. It's basically the yellow parts are the inner parts of the beam emitters and the all the wiring and stuff. And then I was like, well, I can't use that red now for the main body, because it just, there's no reason. I was gonna have that because of the pink, so it'd be kind of like a pink. And then underneath would be the red, so it'd be kind of like, it kind of makes sense. But now I got the blue, and there's no other colors for the red, so I decided to use this dark blue. This is actually the true blue that I've used on my kits, like the Wing Gundam, the Tall Geese 2. So those parts are going to be in this color, which I think makes more sense with the lighter blue. And then, now I've got all these flat colors, which are going to be all in gloss. They're going to be covered with a clear gloss coat. But nothing's metallic anymore, so it seems the silver is going to be out of place. So I decided, going back and thinking of some of the other customs I did, I decided to take the pewter gray I've used before on, like, the Akatsuki custom and the, what else did I use it on? The wagtail. And I'm going to use that for all the limb pieces. So anything that's light green is going to be that. I've got those actually painting right now. They're drying. It's a little colder today, but all the water outside is still water. It's not ice, so it's not freezing, so nothing should crackle, hopefully. If it does, oh well, I'll just sand it down and do it some other time. But I'm gonna try to do as much as I can and actually get some parts assembled for you guys so you can see what it's gonna look like. And so I can see what it's gonna look like eventually. Because I have no idea how this color scheme is gonna turn out. And I got a lot of the actual torso done. I just need to do some of the gray pieces inside, so I want to get those done and actually have the torso assembled, hopefully by the end of today. And then I can see if this color scheme is going to be good or if it's just going to be god awful, because I really don't know. I had to change my entire color scheme, and that's why it is good to have a knockoff, because you can do this stuff. You can make it look terrible, and it's a knockoff. If you mess it up, eh. You mess it up. I would feel terrible if I was doing this to the Bandai version. I really would, because it's something re it's a real one, and I wouldn't want to like ruin it. So it might work. It might be the worst thing ever. The good thing is I can always, sand it down, paint it again in the spring. Something else. Maybe I'll spend the extra money. I just didn't want to spend another $8 on the can of Tamiya. Pearl Red, just to use it for that little bit, because I don't know if I'll ever use it again. I might, but just for those, it's like 8 or 9 pieces I'd have to paint, and that's it. It just seems to be a little too much. So, I might have another video of this. I don't know. I'm doing as much as I can in the time I have. I do have, tomorrow being Christmas Eve, I have that off and Christmas off, so. If it's actually nice, I'll do some more. If not, oh well. I've done so much more than I expected. Like that blood scythe alone was an extra kit, basically. So, wish me luck, and I'll see you at the next review.